Hey guys, welcome to Tech Notebook, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make an LED light glow using the Raspberry Pi and Python. So let's get started.
Here are the things you'll need for this project. So the first thing you'll need is a Raspberry Pi. The second thing you'll need is an SD card of 32 gigabytes of capacity. The third thing you'll need is an LED light, preferably one with a long end and a short end. You'll need a 1K ohms resistor, like this. And you'll need two male to female jumper cables. And finally, you'll need a breadboard to hook it all together.
Okay, so welcome to the code section of this tutorial. So in order to type in all the code, I'm just going to be using the Python shell, but you can use any text editor since we're going to be pasting it into the command line via SSH. So that aside, let's get started. So the first thing we'll need to do is to import two packages. The first one is rpi.gpio. So what we need to do is to type in import and then capital RP, lowercase I, dot all caps GPIO. And then you wanna call it GPIO, so you need to type in as GPIO. And then the next package you'll wanna import is time. So then you just wanna type in import time. So now you wanna set up the pins. So we need to type in GPIO dot set, lowercase s, set mode, and then you want to type in gpio dot bcm, and this is just using the Broadcom names, which is the chip on the Raspberry Pi. So now you want to type in gpio dot setup, and you want to set up our GPIO pin that we're using for outputting, which is GPIO pin 21, and you want to set it up as a pin that outputs a signal. So then you want to type in 21 here, and then GPIO dot out. So the next thing you want to type in is GPIO dot output. And then in here you want to type in pin 21 and GPIO.hot. So the way this works right here is that now we're outputting a signal. So we typed in GPIO.output and we're outputting that signal to pin 21. And then we're outputting a high signal. So the high signal is basically turning on the LED light. So the things that GPIO pins can output is a high signal and a low signal. And since we're outputting a high signal, the LED light will turn on. So now we want the LED light to stay on for a while. So we just need to type in time.sleep. And we are going to type in any value, which is just seconds. So I'm just going to type in 5 seconds for now. And then you want to type in GPIO.output. And then you want to output to pin 21. And you want to output a low signal this time, which will turn off the LED. So GPIO.low. And make sure it's all capital. And finally, you just want to clean up the pins to stop any scripts that are going on. So you just want to type in gpio.cleanup and then open parentheses and close parentheses. And then now you're done with this section. Okay, so you want to have your Raspberry Pi in this orientation right here with the GPIO pins on the right side and the USB ports on the bottom.
And I will also have a PID layout of the Raspberry Pi right in this top right hand corner. So now the first thing you want to do is to take one of your male to female jumper cables and plug the female end into the bottom left pin on the Raspberry Pi, like this. And then you want to plug in the other end into the negative rail and into one of these five. I'm just going to plug it into the top. Then you want to take your resistor and you want to plug one end of the resistor into that exact same one of those five pins. And then you want to plug it into one of the rows right next to it. And then now you want to take your second male to female GPIO pin wire and you want to plug it into the bottom rightmost pin, and that is GPIO 21 on the Raspberry Pi. And then you just want to plug it into one of the rows under the row that the resistor is plugged into. And then finally you want to keep the negative side, which is the shorter side of the LED light, facing towards the resistors row, and the positive side facing towards the cable that we plugged into GPIO pin 21's row. And then you just want to insert that into the breadboard. Put your SD card into the Raspberry Pi. And also you want to get your power supply and also plug that in. And then now you need to connect to the Raspberry Pi via SSH on your computer.
Okay, so now I am in the command line for the Raspberry Pi. I connected via SSH. I have a tutorial on how to connect your Raspberry Pi via SSH, and I will link that tutorial down below in the description if you want to reference that. So now the first command you'll need to type in is nano. And then we need to title the file, so I'm going to title it led.py. And I just want to click enter. And that will open a window for us to paste in all the code that we typed out earlier. So here is the code we typed earlier, so we just want to copy that and paste that into here. There we go. And we just want to click Control X and then Y and enter. And then we wrote to the file. So now in order to run the file, you'll need to type in Python. And then led.py. And then you just want to go and click enter. And then the LED light would have turned on and off after 5 seconds. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.